Hey guys, HDV here, and welcome to a brand new video. Today we've got a lot of stuff to cover. We have a potential hint towards a Pokemon Presents. We have Pokemon Go stuff to cover, Pokemon Sword and Shield, got Pokemon Unite updates, 25th anniversary stuff. There is a lot to cover today. So if you are excited for today's video, as always, make sure to drop a like down below. Let's try and hit 500 likes. It really does help out. Leave a comment with your thoughts on anything we cover in today's video. Subscribe if you're brand new. We keep you up to date with everything to do with the Pokemon franchise. With all of that out of the way though, let's get into the video, and I really hope that you enjoy. So, starting things off, let's take a look at why there might be a potential Pokemon Presents hint because of what Junichi Masuda posted to his Twitter account earlier today. So this was tweeted out from PokeXperto. And they said, Junichi Masuda has shared this photo of his visit to the offices of the Pokemon Company. Remember that these are not the offices where you usually work. So a lot of people are expecting this to be him filming the next Pokemon Presents or something like that, which it very well could be. On the other side of things though, this could also be quite bad, because if he's there filming the next Pokemon Presents, it's not like, oh, he's there now, so it's gonna be next week. These things take like a month to make, with all the like the videoing and the editing and everything like that and all the checks. It's not like a week project. It takes like a month and a half. So if this is indeed Junichi Masuda going to film the next Pokemon Presents, we ain't getting it till like September. However, something else that it could be is him filming the Pokemon Presents that's happening after the one we're getting. So let's say we get one next week. This could be him going to film the next one, which would be in like, I don't know, like October or something. I really don't have a clue. But that's just a couple of things that I want to talk about today, because a lot of people are kind of taking this to hint towards a Pokemon Presents. It could just be him visiting. It's probably that. But a lot of people are expecting it to be something to do with him filming the next Pokemon Presents. So I thought I'd include it in today's video. But yeah, still interesting, because obviously he doesn't work there at that actual building. So interesting that he's gone there. But either way, that's the Junichi Masuda part of the video. Next up, we have a big Pokemon Unite update. Well, it's not really a big update, but it's something that is very, very useful. So basically, if you didn't know, there was a massive patch update a few days ago for Pokemon Unite, buffing, nerfing a bunch of different characters. And Gengar was one of the Pokemon that got nerfed. Well, the Hex ability got nerfed. But as well as that, there was also a big bug on Gengar where like Hex was just messing up loads. That has now been fixed. And as well as that, they've also made an adjustment to the Master Rank. So basically, when you win a Master Rank game, or when you win a game when you're in Master, you get like 6-7 points. When you lose a game, you lose like 15 to 20 points, or even more though. So as you can see, it's a little bit unfortunate. If you're solo queuing, you have to win like 3 or 4 games just to kind of break even with one loss. And let's be honest, if you're solo queuing, you're not going to win every single game. I mean, even if you're in a 5-stat, you're not going to win every single game. So that's actually been adjusted now, so you don't lose as many points when you lose a game when you're in the Master Rank, which is really good. At the moment, there's not really any incentive to play once you hit Master, because it's not like if you finish at a certain world ranking, you get even more tickets. You just hit Master Rank, you get your 20,000 tickets at the end of the season, and that's that. You don't really need to play anymore. Like, yeah, you can play to improve your world ranking, but at the same time, is it really worth it? Like, you're never really gonna be like super top, like on the top 100 leaderboards, unless you're obviously a really, really good player. So yeah, unless they introduce like more tickets for your world ranking, there's really no point of playing, which is why I've not really played too much Pokemon Unite recently. As well as that though, we have another Greninja skin that did just drop today. So this is a promotional image of Greninja's, I don't even know how to say that, Holoatweet? I don't even know, I've probably got that completely wrong. But basically, Greninja's got a new skin now that you can buy. I'm not a huge fan of it really. I think it's like 300 odd gems. I think it's the same price as like the Gardevoir skin and everything like that. I'm not a huge fan of it. I definitely prefer the other Greninja skin, even though that's like 1,000 gems. But yeah, if you are a Greninja main, I guess there's more of an affordable skin now, because the only Greninja skin available was 1,000 gems. Now you've got another one that's like 350. It's not the best skin in the world, but if you wanna, I don't know, get a skin for Greninja if it's your main, well, now you can without spending as much money. Next up, we have some Pokemon Sword and Shield updates. So basically, there's a new max raid event happening right now in Pokemon Sword and Shield. It's running from the 6th to the 8th of August. So there's a new max raid event in Pokemon Sword and Shield. So you can get Vanilluxe Shiny, you can get Seeking, you can get Pinsir, Heracross, Ninjask, and Rotom Fan. So yeah, Shiny Vanilluxe is in dens right now. I don't know what the actual odds are for this, but yeah, it's just a nice little event. Again, I'm still glad they're doing these sort of events for Pokemon Sword and Shield. It's really keeping the game alive. They couldn't really do things like this in previous games because there wasn't really any features to allow them to constantly like do these little mini updates and stuff. But with Dynamax Adventures and raids and stuff, it's very easy to do that. You literally just change what Pokemon appear in the raid. So yeah, when there's always a shiny as well, is even more of an incentive to play. So yeah, Pokemon Sword and Shield doing a really good job. But yeah, that's running basically all weekend. It stops on, well, Sunday. So yeah, if you want to try and get yourself a Vanillic shiny, now's the time to do it. As well as that, the actual updates of the financial stuff for Pokemon Sword and Shield has also been updated, and it's very, very close to being like the most sold Pokemon game of all time. But basically, Pokemon Sword and Shield have sold a total of 21.85 million copies with the most recent update of Nintendo's financial data. They have sold 750,000 units in the last 4 months, which is still kind of mad. Sword and Shield's been out for a long time, and they're still like selling, what's that like, I don't know, nearly 200,000 copies a month, which is still kind of crazy if you think about it. Like, the game's nearly 2 years old. So yeah, still doing really, really well. I get that there's not really another main series game that's come out since Sword and Shield, because obviously we got the DLC, so there's not really anything anyone else wants to buy on the Switch. Like, it's the biggest Pokemon game on the Switch, so if you're gonna get a Pokemon game, you're probably gonna get Pokemon Sword and Shield. I'm sure that the units will take a hit when like Brilliant Diamond Shine Pokemon and Legends Arceus and stuff like that. But yeah, as of right now, it's kind of smashing it. As well as that, we also got the Pokemon Snap update. So they are close to surpassing Pokemon Gold and Silver, which sold 23.1 million copies. By doing so, Pokemon Sword and Shield would get the second place in the best-selling Pokemon game in history, only behind the original Red, Green, and Blue. So yeah, it's not nearly the highest selling Pokemon game of all time, but it's very close to the Gold and Silver one. And yeah, I think Snap, I thought it was there, but it's not on that tweet. But yeah, Snap, I think, has sold like 2 million now or something like that, which is pretty good. Next up, we have Pokemon 25th anniversary news. So basically, three new songs have dropped for the album. Again, kind of out of nowhere. The first one, new music from the album P25 Music on the occasion of the 25th anniversary of Pokemon. So Vince Staples and it's Got 'Em, that's the song title, so we got that one. The next song is Wonderful, I think is what it's called. I don't know if it's like translated badly or whatever, but yeah, Wonderful is the next song. And then the third song, which I think we already knew. No, that's the other one that's just been played. I think the one that we already know about is the one that released like earlier, like a couple weeks ago. I can't remember the artist, but the song was basically already released. But yeah, it's all kind of been like confirmed now and stuff like that. So yeah, that's the Pokemon 25th anniversary update. And then finishing things off, Niantic have actually responded to the massive boycotting situation that's gone on because of the whole update they did in regards to the Pokestop. So PokeExperto tweeted out saying, Niantic will reconsider its approach to interaction distance with Pokestops by assembling a team with its official collaborators. The conclusions will be published on the September the 1st. So this is their actual official statement saying, we will share the findings of the task force by the next in-game season change, September the 1st. As part of this process, we will also be researching, reaching out to community leaders in the coming days to join us in this dialogue. I think that's kind of a cop-out, to be fair. Like, why do you have to wait a whole month to realize that the update is really bad? I think this is a money grab. Apparently, there's like data mines and stuff happening where they're going to introduce a subscription service, and then the Pokestops being like in your radius is apparently like a part of that subscription service, which I think is just not the way to go in the slightest, because they're basically just making people pay for like to be safe playing the game, which is honestly like super, super corrupt. But yeah, I think this is a really, really bad take from Niantic. I don't know why it takes a whole month to realize that it's just not a good idea. They've not heard like one positive response about it. So yeah, the fact that they're taking a whole month is obviously just for money. They're seeing if their like prices, like the money that they make, goes down. If it does, then obviously they'll do the changes. And if it doesn't go down that much and it goes up or whatever, then they'll probably just keep it like that or implement the subscription service. Either way, Pokemon Go, super corrupt game now. I know a lot of people are boycotting it, and a lot of people have stopped playing it. It is what it is. I haven't played it in ages, but yeah, this is definitely not going to get me into playing the game in the slightest.
And I know a lot of content creators and stuff are not playing this game either. Big Pokemon Go content creators as well, so it's obviously taking a massive hit from all these people that are like promoting it for free all the time. But anyway, that's all the news today. What did you think about it all? What are your thoughts on the whole Pokemon Go thing? Are you looking forward to these songs and stuff? I think they're all out now. I think you can literally go listen to them all. What's your thoughts on the Sword and Shield event? What's your thoughts on the Unite stuff? And of course, what do you think this Junichi Masuda picture means as well? That's going to be everything from me, though. Hope you had a fantastic day. Drop a like if you enjoyed. 500 likes. Leave a comment. Subscribe if you're brand new. All that good stuff. Until next time, peace.